What's going on, guys? We are the High Time, and today we are shooting the second episode of our podcast. And today we have a special guest on our show.
Yeah, and today our special guest, he's India number one, Asia number one, and world number five. That's Yash Fateh.
Please, a round of applause for Yash Fateh.
How are you?
Yes.
Good, good evening.
Yeah, I don't stand up.
What's happening?
So Yash, what do you say, like, today's quarantine? How's your life going? What was squash?
Very sad. Nothing to do.
Yeah. So is it nothing, no playing, anything? Is there no practices?
No, hardly any practices. It's and everything because of COVID, everything is gone. Yeah. Hopefully it will revive soon.
But like basically like most of the sports they have started playing like indoor games and all.
Yeah, like the problem with squash is you're inside a room. Yeah. With your opponent who's literally touching you every single time, you know, you all cross each other's path. So that's the problem. That's why, you know, squash is rated like, you know, a very high contact sport, and that's why, you know, people have different countries have been hesitating to give permissions to open up squash courts. So yeah.
But like basically, so mostly, I mean, Goa, you don't really practice anything.
I mean, I am practicing here, but. Like I need to, I think I'm doing solo, I'm practicing by myself.
Yeah.
And but I'm planning on going outside Goa soon, since the borders have they've opened up the borders, so I'll hopefully at least travel within India and play some sports.
Do you have any idea when India want to start with you practicing or
in? I think India, I think everyone is looking at health first and then everything else. So, but I think I hope they start soon. But according to me, I think 2020 is definitely gone. Nothing before Jan 2021.
So yeah, but mostly basically they are like taking precautions on most of the sports. So like any idea? Like I mean, surely get any authority from the Goa government like to start?
No, I think Goa government. I mean, they need to have facilities, squash courts first, and then they'll give us. Approval, but no, I think Goa though, you know, I don't know. Goa anyways, I don't train on government courts because there aren't any government courts. I train on my own facility.
You go to Chennai and Mumbai, right?
Yeah, I go to Chennai and Bombay. But there things have started opening up. Definitely, things are better over there than in Goa.
Recently, what are the last championship you played?
I won the French Junior Open.
How was the experience?
Different. Yeah. France was good. I think.
Yeah, I think you're number one over there now, right?
What?
You French?
No, I was seeded number one, and I didn't expect to win the championship, but I played well, and I won some really close matches,
cool.
I ended up winning. And then after that, after winning, I went to Paris. And I think because I won, the level amount of excitement that was there to see Paris was more, and that's when I got that picture with the in front of Eiffel Tower. Yeah.
I can say from all of us that we all know that once we entered the competition, we didn't expect anything less than the tournament.
Yeah, but I mean, thanks. That's really nice of you guys.
It's not hype or anything, but. The hard work and the dedication and everything that you've gone through, we expect nothing less than you to win a competition when you enter it at your stage of your
career. It's really nice of you all. I think if I have friends like you all, then support, then of course anything is possible.
You also got support. Yeah.
But you see, now your great support, who I have to thank is your dad.
I think whatever I am, it's only because of my mother and father. I think they are the ones who've worked very, very hard behind the scenes. I mean, I am, you know, like whenever I win a tournament, I'm getting on the podium and receiving the trophy.
Yeah.
But every single time, I'm like, I wish my parents are there with me to receive that trophy because they are equally deserving as much as I am. I think because I think they've gone out of their way to, you know, make sure that I get the best facility for squash and, you know, yeah. And I think... Hopefully even Om does well in their
I was just gonna say, I think your brother pushes you to your limits.
I think it's great to have a twin brother. Yeah. Obviously people think that there's a lot of rivalry and all, but I don't think that's the case between us.
I think
I think we both are from in two completely different sports. I play indoor sport, he plays outdoor sport. He plays a team sport, I play an individual sport.
Your dad, he was a cricket player, right?
Yeah, he played cricket for Goa.
As well,
yeah, and uncle played for India. So,
that's nice.
And then I played cricket for school.
Yeah.
And
so
I injured myself.
So, a family full of sportsmen, I see.
Yeah, yes. So
personally, talking about his dad, you know, I know his dad. Personally, his dad supports a lot. I don't know the support he gave me. His family, he's a great family he has.
Yeah.
I really wanted to thank his dad.
Please adopt
and I don't have a lot of friends. I have few friends, and my dad only likes him. Only Jonas.
Ask your dad if he wants to adopt him.
Yeah, he's ready. He's ready.
So
you got a home once you're not
there. Speaking of home, who's the favorite son? You or Om?
No, I think many people ask that, but I think we are both.
Equally
equal when it comes to our parents. I think there's no they don't separate us for any reason. I think they give us we both are pampered the same way, we both are given the same amount of support, everything. And I think even Om is doing he's doing well in his studies, and also started doing well in cricket, and I hope he continues that. And
as you both started, I want to ask you one thing. Like many of them actually, most of the actors like Grecia, like people. How do you cope up with studies plus your sports? Like, you know, can you like tell the audience about it?
I think there's just one answer to that. I think because of friends like you. Because I'm not kidding, because I remember when I used to go, I think school is 10 months in a year. I was never there.
Yeah,
I was there only once in a month or once in 2 months I was there. Otherwise I was in some part of the world. And I think it's just my friends who've helped me. I need to thank you all, because you all were there when whenever I would come back, I would speak to you or reach out to you all. And I think you all would help me a lot to recover my notes and whatever I've missed. And also big thanks to my teachers. I think St. Joseph is without a doubt one of the best schools. Teachers are amazing. And how much ever I talk about our principal headmaster Abito sir,
he's
enough.
Like,
I mean, with us when he's in school, when we were in uniform, he was never like a sir to us. He was like a friend. Yeah. So I think that's one thing you don't see in many principals. That's something rare, and that's the best quality about him. I know that was everyone's concern, but at the end, I ended up. Because I think if the school doesn't support, you can't pursue any extracurricular activity, you can't do anything. But because my school supported so much, I think I'm very grateful to them.
Coming to the topic of the Goa government being, it's not a secret, but it's a known fact that the Goa government really wants on your achievements, but doesn't help you back.
What's the other sport that you like to play except squash?
I think I played cricket when I was in St. Joseph's, and I cycle a lot. I swim. And I think my favorite hobby is to go fishing, and every Goikar loves that. So I think that's one. Yeah, I mean that's one thing I love doing. Just going down anywhere and just casting the rod. And just sitting there, it just releases your tension, stress, whatever.
Do you actually catch any big fish and stuff? Like
I have caught some, not big fish, like medium size.
Okay. And now when you go out like to play go abroad other countries.
Yeah.
So do you get any free time I
don't get any free time. Like when I go up, traveling abroad, obviously my first priority is to complete the tournament and make sure I'm playing the tournament and not focusing on anything else. But after the tournament,
mind cold, because I've experienced sports when you put lots of pressure in your head, you lose concentration.
Yeah. I mean, that is, I mean, that's something I've already experienced and I have to deal with it. Every sportsman has to deal with it.
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing, there's no secret to it. Every person has his own way to deal with it, and everyone has to deal with it if you want to, you know, succeed. But you know, people obviously, there are many who get diverted. Okay, we are going to France, so let's go to Paris first day, we'll explore Paris, and then that's your choice, but at the end you get tired, you're focusing on anything else, your preparation is not good. So I keep that stuff, you know, towards the end of the trip, like if I'm returning back and if I have to see it, then I'll extend my trip for one day.
That's
so
nice.
So would you say that traveling is one of your hobbies then?
I think it's not, it has become like a hobby, I would say. But I love traveling, and in fact, I travel so much that if you ask me anything about airplanes, I know so much that I can literally sell you one airplane. I know everything about it.
Actually, recently, I messaged you about this, remember? I saw you, I was actually in my room, and my dad actually just told me. You actually saw the interview on the 365, I guess.
Yeah.
And I
actually
never knew about this. You like
aeroplane. Yeah. I don't have the money to buy one and all that. But hopefully soon. Yeah, I mean, like I think I have traveled so much. I travel so much that you know, when you travel, you have to if you're traveling in the car, you'll obviously know about different cars. If you're on the ship, you'll obviously know about differences. So same story. Like I know, all that because I've traveled enough to sort of figure out what is what, and it's kind of interesting once you get to know it and when you're around it.
I think you must be over the moon to be back in Goa after so.
No, I'm actually very glad. In one way, I'm very glad that I'm home because I hardly get any time to come back home. Yeah, I'm like, even if I'm coming home, I'm only there for max 2 weeks and then I'm going somewhere else. So I'm glad that I can spend time with family and close friends who I know don't have corona. Yeah, exactly. So I don't spend more than 2 weeks in Goa because in squash our off season is not like 3 months. Our off season is between tournaments. So that's the thing.
Okay, so yes, now we're gonna come with your Q&A questions. Are you ready?
Ready.
Joel, start first.
Okay, you wanted to know what your relationship status is.
Single. Always been single. I'm serious. I swear on squash I'm single. Check my phone.
Because
yeah,
while I was
picking
stone, you remember that day we went to Stonewater?
Yeah.
So like, I asked, oh, is your single?
Yeah,
yeah,
I am single.
And
I
was just, you're like, no, you're not.
I mean, I won't lie. I have friends. I have friends, but I have nothing else. Because I know what's more important in the end. I think I've seen enough people who have destroyed their careers because of, getting diverted, down the wrong path. At such an early stage. I'm saying this because I've realized that there'll be a time to, when I'll be able to sort of like focus on other things in life. But I know that, but that's your way of looking at it.
Even he's calling for you.
It's a good question actually. Once then people like they get fame and all.
Yeah.
Most of them their lifestyle changes.
Yeah.
So like now anytime did you like ever like try to show off your lifestyle or something like anywhere?
No, I think when you come in the limelight, it's a boon and a bane. Like it's got its benefits and it's got its demerits. When you get into a little limelight, people try to drag you into some controversy, which is I think the worst thing, worst feeling ever, because it keeps you up at night. You don't know what other people are thinking.
Yeah.
But at the end, it not really happened. It's happened to a small scale, but I've sort of experienced what a larger scale would feel like, and I definitely don't want to be a part of it. That's why whenever someone asks me a question like on the government or this thing, I'll give the most hypocritical answer and be over in the middle. So, I'm not sure, there's nothing to show off. Like, I think I believe when I step outside the court, I want, I have friends like you and all who like me for who I am, not because of Yash Fateh who plays squash.
Yeah.
So I think that's why I said, you know, I have few friends, you know, because I know the type of friends I have like me because of me, not because of my achievements. So
do you enter like rush to the washroom or something while playing squash? Like some players, like they feel like, no, going to the toilet during the rush time only while playing.
Yeah, I go before every match. I go like 2-3 times to the right. Even if my match is at 10 o'clock in the morning, I'll wake up at 5:36, go to the toilet. For me, I'm running on the court, so I want to feel as light as possible. So, so far I have not got that, you know, feeling that, you know, to go to the bathroom when I'm playing the match. But I know that will come at some stage, so I'm always prepared. And, you know, I'll get it out of the system before I go on the squash court.
So, like, come with that. I would ask, like, now, which is the best ever game you ever played in your whole life career?
I think there are. I can't think of a single one, but it definitely must be. Yet to come, obviously. But I think so far.
Which was the best ever moment you have achieved a lot?
I think obviously when I win the international tournament, when I win a medal for India, I think like I won the US Open in 2017. That was a very proud moment. I was proud of myself at that time, because I think the situation I went through before, it was the first time I went to New York.
Yeah.
Went to America, and it was, I think, -12. I went alone. I was 16, you know, my parents weren't with me, so I think that was quite challenging. And then, you know, time, I didn't realize, you know, but jet lag really hit me hard. And I think I was playing two matches and I almost lost a match, and then I somehow won it, and then I ended up winning the tournament. So I think that was pretty, I was very proud of myself. And I think even in France, I think the semi-finals was really tough, very close, like a nail biter. And I remember the finals, after I won, I removed my socks, and along with my socks, skin came out and blood came out. So I knew that I was playing with a lot of pain, because I was struggling, but somehow I managed through. And no, I think it's not the worst, it's the best. I feel good when I'm, you know, like doing that, because I'm struggling to do something. So I think that's another big moment.
I remember my last was back in 2019. Yeah. I showed you all, right? I coached the team, one team Vadem, right?
he coached like a full team of 5-year-old children.
Okay.
And he came to Mango Sports Club where I used to hang out, and he's like, Chris, I'm a coach. I'm like, you're a coach? I thought, like, you know, coaching some really good players. He's like, that you see that boy there in red? Yeah, he's in my team. This is Tingu.
Really? No. See, I coached under 14 plus two ladies team. Actually, look, coaching actually for me was a big achievement, which I never thought. And even like, bought the team like so far.
If you ever lose a coach, you know who to go.
Yeah, exactly. You can hire him for free.
It was like, for me, to like that way, it was a big achievement. Of course, everyone had their own personal big achievement.
Like,
you know,
strategy though. Both the ladies team that he coached played against each other in the final.
So it's like, I'm the coach of the winning team and the runner-up team.
They were different ages. Of course, you were there, Chris.
Yeah, I know.
All jokes return.
Yeah, you can beat Joel after the shoot.
That's of course you can. So Yash, like, now as we have come to the end of the podcast, like, would you like to tell the young generation, like the people, like motivation, like, how to like have them sports to build up, like how you achieve your dreams?
I think I don't want to sound like a father to people, but to children. But I think all I want to say is, just don't waste your time right now. I think this is a crucial stage when you actually, because trust me, there are many people who, you know, just waste their time right now and they regret when they're 25, 26, because they have nothing to do. And they can't achieve their dreams. So I think just don't do anything stupid that will put your parents, you know, in shame, or that'll make your parents' head go down in the society. And I think that's all. And just make sure you're working hard, studying, and obviously take up squash if you all can. But one thing, don't ride motorbikes. Worst. Don't ride motorbikes, yeah.
With license or without?
No, without license also don't ride. Worst thing.
We are gonna play the game also.
Oh yes! I forgot.
Good reminder, yeah. Okay. So cut that part.
No. This is staying in the podcast.
No, I'll beat you.
Just a bonus round.
Bonus okay. Round.
Blindfolded
and they're gonna put objects inside.
Perfect. For you to
guess
what. Perfect.
Okay. I hope you can't see anything. No, I can't.
Is it tight enough?
Yep.
Good.
Hey.
You
little
cheater. I can't see.
Ready?
Don't take out the blindfold.
No.
Object number one.
Yeah.
And
where's your cover?
This is some kind of statue. Some dragon.
Yes.
Some dragon.
Correct.
We'll get the next one. Yeah. This is some kind of chess piece.
You gotta guess which chess piece.
I gotta guess which chess piece. A pawn?
No, unfortunately.
A bishop?
No.
The queen, king, horse? Yes, it's a horse. I had a horse in
mind. The next item is coming.
Yeah.
So you gotta be careful with this thing, okay?
With what?
This item.
Be careful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Put your hand into it. It's okay.
Hey, what is Henry? Hey, Baba, what is this? Some kind of lizard?
Yes, you're right.
I'm not scared of lizards.
Get a cockroach, Dej.
Okay.
Hey, Baba.
Because don't know, actually, you're just scared of cockroaches.
I'm not scared of cockroaches, Ray.
Because enemy.
Object number four.
Inside.
Some kind of seeds, rice, salt, sugar.
Yes,
sugar.
Rice.
Yeah, I'm pretty good, man.
Your next subject is coming.
Okay.
Good idea.
Cotton.
Yeah. Object number six.
Some kind of remote. Huh? It's a remote, it's got buttons.
It's a remote.
Yeah. What remote?
It's actually a play toy remote.
You all are not putting any shock pens and all, Mare?
No.
Done?
No.
Object number 7.
I put?
Yes.
Where's the object? What's this? Huh?
It's a sign.
Huh? What's this? Some kind of... It's got... What? No, I don't know what...
Any guesses?
It's a hand sign is all we can tell you.
For each...
It's a hand?
For each guess, you get a slap.
No, it's a hand
sign.
Hand sign?
Yes.
Okay. I guessed that.
It's actually peace.
It's
okay.
Peace.
Yeah.
So I said it's a hand, no. Hand.
Okay, your next object.
Oh. It's your finger. Whose finger? Jonas's finger. Jonas?
No.
Whose finger? Whose finger?
Okay, so whoever present the last and final, the best object.
Hey, what is that?
You gotta dip your finger inside that.
Huh?
It's a bowl, you gotta dip your finger in it.
Yeah.
And then what's in there?
You gotta dip your finger in that.
We are not responsible for any injury.
What is this? It's heavy. How do I guess this, yaar?
Divya finger, I don't know, but what is that one finger?
She. What is this? Gross. She. I don't know, sauce?
Go.
Pickle?
Go.
What is this?
Recommend you
tasting
it.
Yuck, what is this?
They don't make a come on.
So okay guys, yeah, we are end of the podcast. Thanks for Yash for coming here. It's a great pleasure coming here.
Great pleasure to be here.
Number one.
Thank you.
Great pleasure. So guys, how you support us, you know, he's a great person. I hope you support him every time.
Yes. Please subscribe,
yeah,
like, share and comment.
Thank you everybody and see you at the next episode. She don't like to party, she like muscle, all she be on the same.